Show me what democracy looks like. Show me what America looks like. Welcome to the Women's March 2022. I love to see your beautiful faces. Thank you so much for being here. This is going to be a fantastic day. We have amazing speakers for you this morning. We have amazing people that are throwing their hat in the ring wanting to represent you. And they are here in your presence, which means that you have the opportunity to speak to them before they get elected. I need you to show our candidates some love. Go ahead and visit their tables, find out more about them. We have some amazing sponsors. We need you to go ahead and go to their table, show them some love. This could not be possible without you and without the tireless efforts of the board of the Women's March and, of course, the tireless efforts and the funds of our sponsors. So thank you for coming. We're going to get started in just a moment. And the House of Representatives has a new resolution recognizing the ERA as having been passed and legitimately a part of the Constitution. They are currently collecting sponsors. We have waited way too long for this. Alice Paul began this fight in 1923. The U.S. is the only one of our modern countries with a Constitution that does not give women their rights. We have waited way too long for this. Today we say our time is now. We will wait no longer. It is time to finally ratify and put the ERA in the Constitution of the United States.
Yeah.
I have a question for you. Who here believes that women should have equal opportunity? Congratulations, you are a feminist. That is all that being a feminist means, that we as women have equal opportunities. And that is what the ERA is about. Our rights in the Constitution. We have waited too long, and it is time now not only to put the ERA in the Constitution, but to elect people that truly represent all of us. The black and brown communities, the gay and the lesbian, transgender community. We need to be pro-choice. We need to be pro-people. We need to be pro-employment. We need to be pro-affordable housing. We need to be pro-voting rights.
Thank you.
And after the primary, regardless of who wins that primary, we come together. and we push Ron DeSantis out of Tallahassee. We're gonna say Ron be gone, right, Amanda? Ron be gone, look at that sign, I love that sign. Ron be gone. We are done with DeSantis in Fort Myers. We are done with DeSantis in Naples. We are done with DeSantis in Charlotte County. We are done with DeSantis all over the state of Florida. Yeah. The only way we get that to happen is by people voting. Do not let them suppress your vote. Do not let that happen. They say it's not happening. It is happening in the state of Florida right now. They are trying to suppress your vote. The more time we allow them to do this, the less time we will have to vote, the fewer rights we will have. They are trying to take our rights away, but right now, we have to stand up for ourselves. We have to stand up for ourselves. And we have to recognize that our future comes from people who live the dream right here. So
now I would like to introduce the future. When we were out protesting in 2020, we had this little tiny protester saying, no justice, no peace, no racist police.
Not true.
True.
Here. Here we go. We have another candidate making their way to the stage. Tell us who you are. District 4 County Commissioner, what is your name?
Danny Hagman.
Danny, you're running for County Commissioner. That's amazing. Congratulations. I am so happy. I am so happy. What are you going to do with the County Commission?
Hopefully make some changes. Like, get some new blood in. Make us heard in all the ways that matter.
So you do know that the County Commissioners in Lee County sit on their dais with a picture of Robert E. Lee behind them. You know that, right? And they were asked to take it down, but they would not take it down. They're going to be taking it down, that's what she says. They're going to be taking
it down when I get in there.
Support your candidate. All right.